Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI barcode generator control. Using the barcode generator control, you can generate and display data in machine-readable format using industry-standard one-dimensional and two-dimensional barcodes. Now, I'll be showing you how easy it is to add the barcode generator control to the .NET MAUI application. I'll also demonstrate how to change the symbology from code 68 to QR code and display input value. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will demonstrate how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI barcode generator into this application. I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI barcode package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Once the package is installed, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the Syncfusion MAUI barcode namespace. Now, initialize the barcode generator control by adding the SF barcode generator tag. To visualize the barcode, I will include the value property and set its value to Syncfusion. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. So, I open the app XAML CS file, add the register license method, and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, refer to the description below. Then press the F5 key to run this application. See now, the barcode is generated for the value provided. Notice here, the barcode occupies entire screen height. Suppose you want to change the dimension of the barcode. Add the height request property with a value of 200 pixels and the width request property with a value of 300 pixels. Look here, the barcode rendered within the specified dimension. Next, I will show you how to use the built-in content types such as code 39, code 39 extended, code 93, and so on. If you want to know the available content type in the barcode control, check on the UG linked to the card above. Here I'm going to use the type code 39. So, add the barcode symbology property. And specify the barcode type as code 39. It allows a character set of digits 0 to 9, uppercase alphabets, and symbols like space and so on. Here, I have provided the value in lowercase. So, change the value based on the code 39 symbology. The barcode is rendered for uppercase and numeric values. Notice here, the input value is not displayed here. You can also display and customize the input value provided in the barcode. I can display it below the barcode by enabling the show text property. Also, define the text spacing property to 25 to add the space between the barcode and the text. To customize the text, I define the text style property. And add the barcode text style property. And set the text color to red. Check now, barcode text is displayed with specified customization. Like text customization, you can also customize the barcode color and background color. To demonstrate, I add the foreground color property to purple and the background property to light cyan. See, the barcode and its background color are changed. Finally, I will show you how to generate the two-dimensional QR code. To do that, I change the barcode type to QR code inside the barcode symbology. Look here, the QR code is generated. When I change the barcode type to data matrix, the data matrix barcode will be generated. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add Syncfusion MAUI Barcode Generator control and a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.